Welcome back, Griffin Nation. I'm Chris Hernandez, and it's time for another edition of On the Hill with Hernandez. During break, CHC women's basketball quietly went on a five-game winning streak and is sitting pretty at the top of the standings, tied with Jefferson and Sciences. They hosted Dominican Insurgency on Tuesday night, so let's check it out. Chestnut Hill is red hot of late, averaging 87.2 points during the streak. Griffin's looking to notch another W against a Chargers team who is also in the playoff hunt. 7-3 run by Dominican early, but Vicky Tumaz snaps it with the tray. Siebold, Gibson, Tumaz, Tawagu's down low, one dribble baseline for the score. Final minute of the first, tough shot right here by Siebold, but gets it to go. Little give and go action to Maya Graham, Gibson, Graham, down the lane in the layup. A minute and a half later, Glenn shovel pass, Wild Goose goes to work, hoop in the harm, converts at the stripe. He'll hold DC to 8 points in the second and are up three at the half. Second possession of the third, we'll let this one ride out. Some nice inside out passing. Trossy to Tumaz, Wild Goose to Tumaz again. Back to Trossy, Gibson, back to Trossy. Trossy looks in, looks out again. Glenn, fake pass, Tumaz with the running jump shot, caps a 7-0 run. 6-point lead now, inbound to Siebold, misses from the corner right here. Wild Goose with the board and kick out. If at first you don't succeed, try again. Goes down this time. Nifty bucket here from number 20. Baseline drive, mid-air switch, and gets it to go. Midway through the fourth, Siebold, quick okey-doke, step back. In your face, give me that money. CC up by 11. Last minute, Chargers try to come back. Tumaz says, not gonna happen. Offensive foul. Griffins are victorious, 80-71. The win pushes the streak to 6 games, which is the longest in program history. Jada Wild Goose ties the season high 24 points and notches her 8th double-double of the season. Cassie Siebold was 4 points shy of her new career high, finishing with 22 points, and Vicky Tumaz was just behind the pair with 18 points. Before we get into a little bit more about these three players and their recent play, here's my post-game interview with Coach West.
Coach, you think the first day of classes had anything to do with the slow start on offense?
No, it was just a slow start. I think it was more out of our routine. Over a break, we were able to get in here in the morning and get some shots up and have shoot-arounds and let them see the ball go in the basket. Today, they're back more to the normal routine, and maybe that's part of it. I don't think class has anything to do with it. It's just different than what we've been doing for the last 6 games or so. And then, but you knew eventually, when they got their legs under them, that they were going to get into it eventually.
Jada and Cassie had 20-plus. Vicky was right behind them, I believe, 18. What do you think was working for them?
A little bit of everything. I mean, Jada did a good job of sealing back to the ball. We got some of their post players in foul trouble early, so we went to small lineups. So we just hammered the ball inside to Jada. And I think the second half, they started paying more attention to her, which opened up things for our perimeter players. Even Shannon and Kaylee did a good job of moving the ball. Vicky made some shots. And then Cassie's just kind of coming into her own, and she's finding ways, finding gaps to attack, and just gives us another weapon because she can hit threes and get to the basket. So she becomes difficult for people to guard.
So now it's on the Bloomfield on the road on Saturday. I mean, I know you guys have an off day tomorrow, but what are you guys going to do to prepare for that one?
Well, we're going to start watching a lot of film. I mean, they're starting to play better. Zane Robinson's back for this second semester, and she's been going off on teams. So we got to come up with a game plan to try to slow her down, and we got to go up there. And it's kind of the elephant in the room for us. So we've been going up there every year, and I think it's time for us to go get one. So they need a day to rest. We'll talk about what they do. We'll go over some game plans, try to make some adjustments, and hit the road and see what happens.
Thanks, Coach. You're awesome.
Thank you.
Now back to the trio. We'll start with Siebold and Tumaz. This 1-2 punch is deadly, and they've been showing it lately. The two are averaging 18 points during the stretch and have 2 games each of 20-plus points. Siebold is a 4-time CAC Rookie of the Week, and she's my leader in the Rookie of the Year race. Tumaz is also in discussion for Player of the Year. As for Wild Goose, ride her down for a double-double every single game. The junior has the most double-doubles in a 3-year span in program history. Plus, she's 6 away from joining the 1,000-point club. The setting for this historic moment cannot get any better. This Saturday at Bloomfield at 1. More about that game on tomorrow's episode. So that's all for today. Thanks for spending some time with me on the Hill. I'm Chris Hernandez, and I'll see you next time.